Are helicopters dead? Bell wins a huge tiltrotor contract, and this may change aviation forever. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Big contracts are nothing new in U.S. military procurement, but this one was bigger than most. The U.S. Army's future long-range assault aircraft program is designed to replace the Army's venerable Sikorsky UH-60 Black Hawk as part of the larger future vertical lift program. And the Army has chosen a winner, the Bell V-280 Valor tiltrotor. Future Army doctrine anticipates combat scenarios with advanced scout helicopters and unmanned drones used to control an area, allowing the FLRAA assault aircraft to bring in troops. Now, this kind of mission has been common since the Vietnam War, but experience in that war showed that helicopters are extremely vulnerable, and as importantly, they're slow. Now, the Valor is far from slow, with a 320-mile-per-hour cruise speed and a combat range between 600 and 900 miles, powered by two Rolls-Royce AE1107F turboshaft engines. The aircraft has a crew of four and is designed to carry 14 troops, and can carry slung loads up to 10,000 pounds using dual cargo hooks. The airframe is built with metals and carbon fiber reinforced composites and uses a triple redundant fly-by-wire control system. Like the current service tiltrotor, the V-22 Osprey, the turboshaft engines at the ends of the stub wings are cross-connected with a drive shaft, allowing both rotors to be driven by a single engine in an emergency. The engines are derivatives of the power plants used in the Osprey, but with higher power, and the V-280 has a lower disc loading for greater hover efficiency. The program was built around MBSE principles with a digital thread used to decrease program risk and, as importantly, to control unit costs. Now, final unit costs are dependent on the size of the program by macroeconomic factors like inflation and on the configuration of production aircraft. According to Bloomberg, the Army contract may be worth up to $1.3 billion and aims to deliver production aircraft by 2030. A major program and aim for the Army is to test whether new engineering technologies and procurement systems can deliver modern aircraft without the delays and cost overruns seen in previous programs such as the Osprey. Overall, the market is huge, with estimates ranging from $60 to $90 billion, and Bell's victory would appear to guarantee the success of the firm's military aircraft business for decades to come. Similarly, the loser, Lockheed Boeing's Defiant X coaxial rotor helicopter, may signal a sea change away from pure helicopters worldwide. Business analysts such as Roman Schweitzer of Cohen Research have written that the loss may put the viability of Boeing's helicopter business in question, although the firm is bullish on Boeing overall. If so, the Pentagon has some interesting choices to make. Go all in on tiltrotor technology and possibly face a future with a single source for critical aviation technology, or purchase coaxial rotor helicopters as well to keep the Lockheed Martin Boeing team in the vertical business. Service-wide standardization has benefits. So does supply chain diversification. With up to $90 billion of market share to be won, it's very possible that the helicopter as a concept won't go down without a fight. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.